Hello friends, today we discuss one important theory on motivation, the needs theory on motivation. Needs theory is often referred in many names such as three needs theory, McClelland's theory of needs, McClelland's motivation theory, acquired needs theory, learned needs theory, achievement motivation theory, etc. No other motivation theory is known in as many names as McClelland's theory. As most of the names indicated, this theory was propounded by McClelland. His full name is David Clarence McClelland. David Clarence McClelland was an American psychologist. He was born in 1917 and died in the year 1998. At the age of 81. It is believed that McClelland developed this theory in the year 1961 along with his associate John Atkinson. McClelland's needs theory is a motivation theory. This motivation theory can be considered as in the nature of Maslow's need hierarchy theory, because similar to Maslow's theory, this theory also has individual needs as the central focus of motivation. We have studied that Maslow's theory explained five levels of human needs and their order of activation. But in the theory given by McClelland, human beings have three types of needs. That means McClelland's motivation theory proposes that in order to motivate an individual or an employee, the organization should offer opportunity to satisfy three types of human needs. These needs are the need for power, need for affiliation, and need for achievement. Thus, just like many other motivation theories, McClelland's theory also was built on human needs. We can get into the details of the needs described by McClelland. As already mentioned, three needs theory categorizes human needs into three. These needs are need for power, need for affiliation, and need for achievement. The theory says that all human beings have all these three needs. However, there may be variations in the intensity of needs in different persons. These variations mainly occur due to differences in nature, culture, and social environments. We can see the three needs described by McClelland. The first need is the need for power. What is power? Power is the authority and ability of a person to influence others and to get things done through them. Power gives a person some superiority over others. Some persons enjoy this superiority. As far as such persons are concerned, power is the opportunity to dominate, influence, and control others. Such people look for positions and leadership. They like to set goals, make decisions, and direct the activities of others. Such people would be happy when they get some people to obey their instructions. Need for power is the desire to influence another individual's behavior. In other words, it is the desire to have control over others and also to be influential. Thus, the individuals who are motivated by power have a strong urge to influence and control others. They wish that their views and ideas should dominate others because they want to lead, guide, and control others. When they get an opportunity to accomplish their need for power, they become more loyal to the organization they work for. Need for power need not be taken negatively always. Research shows that the individuals with greater need for power are active and energetic and they perform better than those possessing lesser need for power. Generally, managers with higher need for power turn out to be more efficient and successful. Power can be viewed as the need that helps the people to work for the organization. It can also be considered as the need that motivates people. It is the need that guides the efforts of people towards the attainment of organizational goals. However, power has positive and negative sides. Power may be of two types: personalized power and socialized power. When power is used to make personal benefits, it becomes personalized power. Some people are interested in personalized power. Such persons make use of the power for their personal growth and development. Some others seek socialized power. They use the power for the welfare of the organization and its people. Their intention is to ensure the survival, growth, and achievement of the organization. Research shows that most of the effective managers have higher needs for socialized power. The managers with high socialized power make use of the power for the benefit of their organization. Organizations require managers with higher socialized power. Next need is the need for affiliation. Need for affiliation is the need for frank and fair interpersonal relationships. It is the desire for relationships based on cooperation and mutual understanding. The individuals who are motivated by affiliation have the desire for friendly and supportive relations and environment. Need for affiliation is a social need. It is the need for developing relationships with people. It is the need for making companionships. Such people would be happy in an organizational environment as they get enough opportunities to interact with others. Persons with higher affiliation needs perform better when they are along with other people. They work better when they are part of a team. The managers should be vigilant when they assign duties to such people. The people with affiliation needs dislike isolated environments. They cannot enjoy loneliness. Their productivity lowers in isolated situations. Individuals having higher affiliation needs prefer working in an environment providing greater personal interactions. Such people desire to keep good relations with all. Therefore, managers should assign teamwork to such people. Teamwork inspires such people and they get motivated highly in such environments. They want to keep and develop relations. Studies reveal that highly effective and successful managers have stronger needs for affiliation. Such managers can easily create and develop good relations with various groups of people. Such managers can bring in proper coordination in the organization. The next need is the need for achievement. Need for achievement is the desire to excel, to accomplish the maximum in relation to a set of standards or to achieve success. The individuals with high achievement needs become motivated when they complete competing and challenging works. Such individuals enjoy maximum satisfaction in performing things better than others. They perceive achievement of goals as a reward and value it more than a financial reward. They have a strong desire for getting feedbacks on their achievement. They collect feedbacks on their tasks and get satisfied with the positive comments. Higher achievement is directly related to higher performances. The individuals with higher achievement needs look for innovative ways of performing the job. They are also interested in getting promotions. They enjoy challenging positions and responsibilities. In the case of business, we can definitely say that successful entrepreneurs have higher needs for achievement. They want to accomplish reasonably challenging goals through their own efforts. Need for achievement is the need for personal accomplishment and success. McClelland found that high achievers differentiate themselves from others by their desire to do things in a way better than others do. You might have noticed some people who claim that they can do certain tasks in a way better than the others do. You might have heard that some of your friends say that they can teach the topic in a way better than the teacher did. Such persons have higher needs for achievement. They are the people who enjoy their achievements. Such people perform things well and wish to get rapid feedbacks on their performances. When they get a favorable feedback, they get motivated and it leads them for better performance. McClelland was of the opinion that in order to succeed in business, the people must have the need for achievement. Persons with higher needs for achievement have certain characteristics. Firstly, such persons like to take personal responsibilities. They want to find solutions to problems. They like to take calculated risks. They usually set moderate and attainable targets because they prefer winning rather than losing. The achievers are also interested in feedbacks on their performance. They like to know how well they are doing things. They enjoy attaining tasks rather than earning money. The need for achievement is the desire to achieve something. If you are a teacher with higher needs for achievement, you can enjoy the success of students. You will be happy when you are recognized on that basis. If you are a painter, you will be happy to create your masterpiece and will be the happiest when you are appreciated by many just because of that painting. Need for achievement is the need that drives a person to work and achieve for targets. Okay, now we have seen three needs of human beings as explained by McClelland's needs theory. In the theory, McClelland proposes that each person falls into these three types of needs. However, the intensity of these needs may vary based on his environment, personal preferences, and experiences. McClelland describes that an individual's culture and life experiences influence his needs. However, it's a fact that regardless of our gender, education, or age, we all have these three motivating needs. And one of these will be our dominant motivating need. In some people, the dominating need may be affiliation. In some others, it may be power. And in some another, it may be the need for achievement. That means, even though all these three needs are there in all persons, one of these may have dominance over and above the other two. This domination is taking place by the influence of culture, environment, and experiences. When we analyze the three needs theory, we can understand that David McClelland developed this theory as a different version of Maslow's theory. McClelland is not talking about the need for food and water. He is silent about such basic needs of human beings. He is not talking about psychological needs such as love and care. But he is talking about a different version of these needs. His needs are power, affiliation, and achievement. Power is the dominance over others. Affiliation is the interaction with others. Achievement is becoming victorious among others. All needs are related to others. All are connected to society. All needs are developed out of social environment. These needs are learned needs from the experiences in the society. McClelland's needs theory is based on learned needs of human beings. Learned needs are those needs which generate out of social life or those we obtain from the social life. Needs for food and water are innate needs. They are the needs within human beings by birth. No need to teach about such needs. McClelland is silent about such needs. His theory is about those needs which are aroused out of learning. The need for jewelry or two-wheeler is not an inborn need. Need for job or professional degree is not an innate need. These needs arouse because of social life. These are the needs of society and environment. It may get from learning and experience. It may get from friends, parents and teachers. It may get from social environment. Considering the preferences given to learned needs, McClelland's theory of needs is often referred as learned needs theory. On the other side, McClelland says about acquired needs. What are acquired needs? Acquired needs are acquiring from society. They are aroused out of social life. Similar to learned needs, acquired needs are acquiring from the environment. Both needs are more or less similar in nature. Such needs are not inborn. They are acquired from environment. Because of this, McClelland's theory is also called acquired needs theory. When we look into the practical importance of the theory, we can definitely say that McClelland's theory of needs help managers in developing strategies to motivate employees. The biggest challenge for any company is to constantly motivate its employees. This theory enlightens managers about how to motivate their employees. According to this theory, at the workplace, the employees have three major needs: need for achievement, need for power, and need for affiliation. The managers should take steps to satisfy such needs. Then the employees will be motivated. The theory also advises managers about the strategies to be adopted in assigning tasks to employees. According to McClelland's theory, companies should give challenging tasks to those people who fall under need for achievement. Such people can enjoy victories over challenging tasks. When managers assign challenging tasks to such employees, they work at their maximum efficiency to attain the targets because such attainments are enjoyed by such people. They feel better when they complete their tasks. Similarly, those tasks which require persuasion or power to influence should be given to those people who fall under need for power. Whereas need for affiliation is another matrix which is ideal for those people who are more interested in maintaining social relations at work. Thus, the employees of the company are given tasks according to their needs and it helps in motivating employees. Nowadays, employee motivation is a huge task for the managers. McClelland's theory solves this problem to a great extent by identifying needs of employees first and then giving them job role according to their needs. Another advantage of this theory is that it makes the employees satisfied. As already mentioned, the managers are assigning tasks according to the tastes and preferences, and therefore they can enjoy such tasks. Thus, the theory ensures that the company has satisfied employees. When we consider the disadvantages of the theory, the first thing is that The theory does not consider the most basic physiological needs of human beings. The innate needs of human body are not get much relevance in the theory. The theory talks about social needs only. Another practical problem is the allocation of jobs. If a person with lower qualification and experience and working in the lower order has higher needs for power, it is difficult for the manager to post him at a powerful managerial post. The manager cannot assign powerful and responsible duties to a lesser qualified lower level employee just because of their higher needs of power. Okay, so far we have been discussing the three needs theory of McClelland. Hope that you could understand the theory. We can meet in the next class with another topic.